got a little gift, a little present from China. This is the Sterlingkit M12 2.6 cc mini four-stroke gasoline engine model water-cooled cooling structure. That's the name of it on Sterlingkit, and it was thing was $299. They gave me they gave me $35.99 discount. So $266 free shipping all the way from Shanghai, China, wherever it is, Shenzhen, China, something like that. So I ordered it on February the 13th. And I just clicked on it. Sterlingkit, they have a site, maybe it's the Banggood site. But I clicked on it, pay with PayPal, yeah, clickety-click. And they send you a confirmation email. And you can track it if you want. I didn't track it, I just waited. And on March the 10th, which I believe was a Friday, so it took less than a month. Alright. So that's what you get. Nothing else. So let's see what we got here. It's on a wooden base. It's pretty heavy. There's space for three AA batteries. Or three, yeah, AA's. An ignition module. Got the little pads. That's nice. 6 inches by 4 3/4. The flywheels are maybe 2 1/4, 2 1/8. I'd say 2 1/8 on those. So, yeah, this side, this flywheel has a T-slot in it, and I'm sure that's for you can put your drill in there, your electric drill, and it also has an old Briggs & Stratton type collar for the knot, with a notch in it for your starter. See the push rods here, there's a cover on the push rods. The first thing I want to take off because I want to look at the rockers. And then, oh, really cool little fuel tank. Little fuel tank with a rubber gasket and a tiny, tiny hole in the middle. That's going to be easy to lose. And then it has a water jacket, so you squirt water in there to keep it cool. So I'm going to have to get some batteries, and I'm going to have to read the instructions. This is a mini engine. It's made of brass and stainless steel. The stroke is 12 millimeters. The bore is 13 millimeters, so it's almost over square. So it says here, its starting can be divided into two ways, external force, electric drill, and manual starting. Engine startup steps, check the wiring of the engine from the board, connect the fuel tank pipeline, and install a number 5 battery, 1.5 volts. It looks like the spark plug is already connected. The fuel tank, I didn't get anything as far as, it looks like to me, that the fuel tank is all connected. There's a banjo. This is called a banjo right here. And that runs into the carburetor. Use gasoline number 95 number to fill the fuel tank. What's that? 95 octane? After the filling is completed, turn the flywheel clockwise on the right side of the engine, power switch surface. For many turns, no air can be generated. Turn on the power switch and quickly rotate the flywheel clockwise to the right side of the engine. Power switch surface to start the engine. Precautions. If the ignition device is normal and the cylinder compression is normal, if the machine cannot start normally, it is very likely that the carburetor oil needle needs to be adjusted. The oil needle. Well, I think they mean the needle valve. So obviously they use some kind of a translation program. It didn't do very well. After tightening the main oil needle valve on the carburetor, oil, sometimes petrol, is oil, gas. One quarter turn and start the flywheel so that the mixing ratio of the gasoline and air can reach the normal working mixing ratio. When the machine stops, the power switch should be turned off. The engine is water cooled and you need to add water before each work. When you finish the work, entering the carburetor. When you finish the work, you need to save the water. Save your water. Okay. The carburetor oil needle valve has been adjusted in the best position before shipment. It is not recommended to make a large adjustment. It can be fine-tuned for different fuels. The cylinder head cover can be disassembled and lubricated on the valve mechanism. The engine needs a new battery. Make sure it has enough voltage for the igniter to work properly. You need to hold the carburetor port by hand and rotate the flywheel. The piston allows the engine to suck fuel into the carburetor. So they're talking about choking it with your finger over the carburetor and running it through to get it started. Add no more than 4 milliliters of lubricating oil to the crankcase to ensure splash lubrication of the crankshaft. What kind of fuel and amount to use? The oil tank capacity is 15 milliliters. I think that's fuel tank again. The engine can use gasoline and aviation kerosene. The engine needs to add 4% lubricating oil to the fuel. If there is no compression, there should be a foreign body entering the engine, which prevents the valve from closing normally. There are three ways to try to solve it. Put a few drops of lubricating oil on the carburetor and use an electric drill to drive the engine for a while. Under the action of the lubricating oil, the foreign matter is discharged to restore the cylinder pressure. And that's it. That's your instructions. Good luck. So what we'll be doing is hooking it all up as advertised and trying to get this started in the next video. So be sure to like and subscribe, and you can look down in the links below. I put some links to some of the various tools I use.